How's it going, guys? Noah's back here. Gonna be reviewing the SOL 3-piece kit. I personally got this one off Amazon, but they sell them in most outdoor stores. I know they sell them at the PX, NEX. They're pretty, not too expensive. This one was about $40 off Amazon. Doesn't come with all the stuff that I put inside of it. I added a bunch of extra stuff just because I needed it, and you know, not every made kit is complete, I guess. Mostly got it because of the medical supplies. Obviously, there's still some stuff I need in here, like you're gonna notice some quick clot would be nice. But other than that, I'm pretty happy with this kit and what I've done with it so far. So, talking about the bag itself, it's a basic blaze orange, you know. This fabric is kind of like a balloon plus a tent fabric, I guess, combined. And it's pretty durable. I mean, I've thrown it around a few times. It can take a beating. Also, another little cool thing is the zipper pools right here. They're water resistant. So, you know, if you're crossing a river, hold this thing above your head and, you know, it's not going to get too much water inside. So that's pretty great. So, getting right into the bag. Also, it has these total grab handles, so you could either carry it around, strap it to a bag, tie it up to a tree, whatever you want. Alright, getting right into the bag. Opens up all the way like a clamshell. Pretty nice. Move it in front of the camera so you can see it. But here it is. First thing you can notice is a little kerosene block. This is an emergency fire starter. Prepared Mind 101 has said these are great for emergency fire starting, and I agree completely. Just makes everything easier. If you really need a fire, no doubt those things are going to get it going. If the wood's wet, it doesn't even matter. That thing's going to get it blazing. So right here is a little add-on pouch. It comes empty. I think that's what they call the add-on pouch, I guess, if you want to add stuff to it. But I've added stuff to both sides, so. Got a 12-hour beeswax candle. Pretty nice. I love beeswax candles. They last pretty long. Got a mini Bic lighter. Why do everything the hard way? Blue to match the color scheme of the everything else. Right here, got a little Swiss Tech tool. This is great. Has wire cutters in the back here. Normal pliers up front, three different size flathead, you know, large, medium, small, and three different size Phillips. My bad. Also, a little nail file on here somewhere. Here, let's see if I can find it. Oops. Okay, here it is, right here. So if you wanted to condition your nails, I guess, but. Don't really use it for that, not its main purpose. Just really nice to have a nice little multi-tool. A nice light one that fits in this bag right here. And you can see, I mixed everything up. It says medical supplies over here and then survival tools and gear repair over here. But this is actually my second time recording this video. The first one got deleted, sadly. Which really sucks because I thought I did a great job on it. So this is actually the medical stuff I'm going to be pulling out right now. Start off with some heavy duty shears. These are really nice. You can put two fingers in the bottom one, one finger up top. This can cut through pretty much anything. The cord, the skin, I guess, if you needed to perform some surgery. They're pretty nice heavy duty shears. Nothing like the Leatherman Raptor or whatever they're called, but they're definitely get the job done. This is some little tubing. I added in this in here myself. So I'm going to put all the stuff that I added in over here to the side, just so you know what comes with it and what doesn't. This added in here. It's just some little plastic tubing you can use for a straw. You can use it to tie something off, just to stop the bleeding, whatever you need it to do. Here it is right here. Or I have a slingshot in my pack, so I can use this as an extra band if I really wanted to. Some sterile gloves. This is nice. If you're performing surgery or trying to get a bullet, something out of somebody, don't want to get your hands all bloody, don't want to cause an infection if they, you know, really needed it. Now, this is some surgical, or sorry, not surgical, medical tape. It's kind of dirty. Nice, decent size roll, probably too much than you would need. But yeah, that's nice. Military tourniquet. Added this one in here myself. This is great to have. You can make a sling. You can make, you could tie off bleeding. You know, just all around great to have. And then it has little hooks up top too. You could also use this to strap gear, you know, just use it as regular rope. That's there. This is a heavy, large H&H compressed gauze. This is pretty nice. Sterile until opened. There's the dimensions right there for anybody who cares. Single use. It's nice. This I added in there. Now we're getting to the stuff that comes with the pack. So we got these really nice, easy use. This is supposed to be like a one-handed operation thing, so you could open it up right here and easily get into the band-aid and apply it by yourself. I got 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. These are like alcohol prep pads. I'm pretty sure you could use, pretty sure you could use these as tinder too if they're alcohol prep pads. But yeah. I'm not really sure what this is. This is a povidone iodine solution, antiseptic sterile solution. Pretty sure this is a, like, if you're gonna perform surgery or whatnot, you use this just to make sure they don't get infected. Or it could be wrong. You could tell me in the description what this is used for, because I honestly don't know. It's a pretty nice bag. You can't really reseal it, so I guess you'd use the whole thing in one go. Not really sure. So if you know what it's used for, go ahead and tell me in the description. I mostly use this out of this bag. This is the thing I use the most. Sting relief. Mosquitoes suck out here, so you know. Great to have. Got some diphen. Not even gonna try to pronounce that. Leave it to you guys. But let's see what it's for right here. It says uses temporarily relieves these symptoms due to hay fever or respiratory allergies. So runny nose, sneezing, itchy nose or throat, itchy or watery eyes. Temporarily relieves these symptoms due to common cold, runny nose, sneezing. Oh, so that's nice. Triple antibiotic. I have a few of these in here. Let me get the camera to focus. There we go. I have a few of these. Then I have a bunch of ibuprofens. I can have about... Ooh, come on. Yeah, there you go. Everybody knows what ibuprofen's used for. More of the pink stuff. More of the orange ibuprofen. Bunch more of the triple antibiotic. More ibuprofen. More triple antibiotic. So that's about 4 ibuprofen. Skin tact wipe. Not sure what this is for. Somebody else I'm with might know what it's for though, so it's always good to have. Don't want to just rip everything out of the pack. There's some bigger band-aids. Got 2 of these big ones. Easy access bandages. It's really nice. You know, these are the ones for like knee scrapes, elbow scrapes, whatever. Sting relief. Have some in here, but these are like the single-use ones. Just in case I run out of the main one. These are great. You know, bee, wasp, whatever you need. These are butterfly bandages. Holds deeper cuts together. You know, so it could heal it by itself. I think this is like another bandage right here. Not really sure. You can tell me what this is for. I wouldn't know. Oh, let's see. Got five of these large bobby pins. You could use this for fixing clothes, making a shelter, maybe holding together a large wound, just whatever you could think of. And I dropped one. That's great. I'm just dropping everything. Yeah. Got these fancy tweezers in this nice little secluded container. They got some pretty nice fine points on them. Let's see. Four of these medium-sized gauze. These are nice. I could use the medical tape for these too. So four of these medium-sized ones, I think. Are they all the same size right here? Oh no, I guess I got two of these ones. So 3-inch by 3-inch. And then two of the 3-inch by 4-inch. And then also two small ones, 2-inch by 2-inch. And then two large ones, 4-inch by 4-inch. And then some moleskin. This is great to have if you're having trouble right there on your heel, if you have really uncomfortable shoes, you know, this is great to put over that. You really want to put it right over it as soon as you start feeling that. Otherwise, it's going to get really bad really fast. So that's about all the medical stuff, you know. All this right here I added to myself. So far, that's all the stuff I added to myself. Just all the stuff that comes with it. Just to let you see. Let me get a sip of my water. Yeah, that's about all that medical stuff. Even though it says survival side, you know. And then right here, right off the bat, got four bundles of these tiny, tiny ropes. Not sure about how much feed this is, but it's really nice, tightly packed. It comes with this rope. It comes with a really tiny headlight. I keep the battery, the second battery in here, reversed so it doesn't use up all the batteries when I don't want it to. This is great to have, you know, if you're just using this to survive out in the wild, I guess you would say. And you're traveling during the night, that's great to have. Oh, excuse me. Duct tape. I've used some of this already. Everybody knows you use for duct tape, repairing shelter, repairing clothes, taping somebody's mouth shut, you know, whatever you want to use it for. And it fell off. I'll pick that one up later. Crazy glue. This is great to have. This is the one you take out and then you just wipe it over whatever you need to. I'm not really going to think that's going to focus. But you know what it looks like. It's a little brush. Nice little size container of it. Repairing stuff, closing up a small cut. Alright. I'm going to do another review on this right now, because this is my second time recording this. But I just thought, just to add some more fun to it, this is the tinder it comes with. It's like a little tinder quick, waxy, cotton type thing. Pretty much you break it apart, open it up a little bit, and then you could light it with this little thing. It's like a lighter without the fluid, so it just throws off sparks. Kind of annoying to use, but, you know, once you get used to it, it's pretty easy. And then, I guess we're going to record that right now, so I'll zoom you guys in. Alright, we're back. So right here is this stuff. They both come in these little packages, and that's great because just in case some water gets in, you know, these stay a little bit safer. And it's bigger to grab too, I guess you would say. So here's the tinder right here. It feels like waxy cotton, I guess you would say. And this is my second time using this too. It comes with four of them, just in case. Yeah, it doesn't come with just three. But if you really wanted to, here, let me show you. Using the scissors right here, you could cut this in half. Yeah, scissors work pretty well for anybody who cares. And then, you know, you could really fluff out that cotton. Just get it nice and fluffy and fibrous. Because the sparks are going to catch on it. Okay, the first time I used this thing was pretty difficult. But you just want to make sure it's nice and fluffy. There it is right there. Whew. There we go. It's lit up. So, this will let you see how long that burns. You know, definitely enough to start a little fire. Just have your small sticks going in a certain pile, and then have your larger sticks going in another one. But yeah, it's a basic fire starter, you know, just a little striker. It's kind of difficult to use at first. Throws off tiny sparks, but if you have the right tinder, it's good enough. So I think it's about like a 30-second, 40-second burn time for just half the tinder. I don't want to use them all, just in case I actually do have to use this kit sometime. So I can get about 5 more fires out of this one. And, you know, if I find some dry stuff, try to spark it with this. Use the other fire starting thing that I have right here. I could break this up into little pieces and use that if I really needed to. This will last a while. And I also have a candle, just in case I want to, you know, get the fire going. Once I have a nice little flame on the candle, then I can use that to start my fire. So I could use even smaller pieces of this. Ooh, try to get the focus, zoom out a little bit. Use even smaller pieces of this just so, you know, lighting up the candle and using a candle light the fire. But there's a bunch of different ways to do it. And we'll get back to the main little pouch. So yeah, that nice little thing comes with the pack itself. There's the rest of it right here. Next up, I love how they added this. This is a 2 really large folded up tinfoils. And this is really durable tinfoil too. It's not like the stuff you use at home. It actually has some strength to it. But anybody who is fascinated with like survival stuff or adventuring, or if you just went camping in general, you know you could use these to make a bowl. Maybe make a little spoon to eat, or just laying it down as a platform for your fire if the ground is wet. So, you know, it has a lot of uses. Or wrapping up a fish if you catch one, you know. Great thing to have. It's another little cool thing they added right here. 45 life-saving tools and techniques by Buck Tilton. So, you know, it has it's a pretty large pamphlet. Has a bunch of stuff, information here if you need to use it or if you forget how to do certain things, which is great, you know, if you are new to like survival or stuff like that. It's great to have one of these, like fold it back up the right way. Yeah, I guess that's good enough. And there's that. Yeah, and here's another little bundle of the orange blaze orange paracord with like black on it, just to match the whole color scheme. I just got this one, and then this also has smaller pieces of cord inside of it. Everybody who's used paracord knows. And then you could use that cord to start a fire because it burns pretty easily. So between the 4 bundles of rope and then that little piece of or bundle of paracord, I have enough rope. Let's see, we got 1, 2, 3. I know we got 3 in here. If I could find it. Alright, well, we got 3 of these small zip ties. These could be used for repairing clothes, repairing shelter. You know, they have their uses. It's great to have zip ties. And then we have 2 of these larger ones that come with the pack. And these are great too. Just for the heavier stuff. Like, I'd probably use these for shelter just because they're a little bit more durable. If you really wanted to, I would suggest putting some military-grade zip ties up in here, because those will do the job better than these smaller plastic ones. And obviously, you need a cutting tool. I just have a little Boy Scouts knife in here. I've used it a few times. Had it for about 4 years now.
has a regular knife, saw, scissors, can opener, you know, just the regular stuff. It's great to have a cutting tool. Yeah, most of the time, or actually all the time, I'll have my main EDC blade, just the 511. I have this one for about a year now, so it's pretty nice. I like it. So between that and this right here, I have a cutting tool to use. So I put this one in here myself, and I put this. Okay, so just to separate everything. I put this one in here myself just because when I'm building a shelter, it comes with one large Mylar blanket, but I'd want to use one for the shelter, you know, build a nice little fort, and then use this one to wrap myself up with, just so it's more comfortable, I guess. But yeah, you can see this one's 52 inches by 84, waterproof and weatherproof, and it's made of durable insulation Mylar. And then this one right here is a lot bigger. I never opened it before. I don't want to ruin it and then not be able to fold it back up. But I think it's like one side is a blaze orange, which is great for signaling, and the other side is the reflective material, you know, which is great for keeping up heat. Hawaii isn't necessarily cold, so it's not really my main worry. But it does get cold sometimes at night. I think the lowest it's ever got was like 58 or something like that, which isn't cold, but just for morale. It's great to have. But yeah, that's about everything in this pack. As you can see, this pack is nice and lightweight once it's completely empty. So the pack doesn't weigh much at all. It's great to add to a little kit. And right here it says, made in Indonesia. So, you know, it's none of that China crap for anybody who cares. But yeah, it has everything separated, obviously. This is my second time recording the video, so I mixed it up. Medical supplies, survival tools and gear, and then they just give you this pack. I guess to just like add on extra stuff, but I added on extra stuff in other places too. But yeah, on this side over here, this all the stuff I added, and that side up here, this all the stuff that comes with it. So it comes with a lot of stuff.
Is it worth $40? I don't think so. Probably a little bit less, just because of how much it comes with and how much you should add to it. But you know, it's personal preference.
And then we're up here camping at Peacock Flat still. Second time recording this video. I actually hate that I have to try again. But, you know, this one's better now because I worked a little bit more towards it. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I enjoy all the support. If you have any other questions, nice to have comments on my videos. If you think I should take away or add certain items, that'd be great too, you know. Just go ahead and spam the comment section. And then share the videos with your friends if you think they'd be interested. Just trying to get my channel more noticed for now. Thanks for watching.